stuff in the shed. I can almost feel a little air conditioning. I read that the air quality is like really unhealthy, so I'm gonna be very, very brief. Welcome to our opening concert of the Norfolk Chamber Music Festival. I think arguably the oldest chamber music festival in the US, and I think it's fitting that we open with a program of world premieres by young composers, because 100 years ago at the original Norfolk Festival, that was a festival that concentrated on music by living composers. So the works you hear tonight will be the first time anyone has heard these works. These are works by composers that have been selected by very, very competitive auditions. There are over 100 applicants to this program, and Martin has the difficult job of selecting the five whose works we hear tonight. They've been here for around 9 days working their tails off day and night, rehearsing, having seminars with Martin and other composers, revising their pieces. And so this concert is the culmination of that. And so thank you for being here and supporting their performances and the music. Just as a quick reminder, next week we have the first concerts of the chamber session that begin on Thursday night with our Emerging Artist Series concert, and then continue on Friday night and Saturday morning and Saturday evening. So I hope you can join us for that too. So that's all I'm gonna say. I'd like to introduce Martin Bresnick, the director of the New Music Workshop. Thanks.
I want to simply echo first Melvin's sense of joy and excitement to see so many of you here. Over the years that we've been doing this workshop, we've developed a small but extremely loyal audience, and I'm delighted to say that yes, that is air conditioning now here in this space. After all these years, the first time in 100 years, and we're very grateful for it, and I think it assures the next 100 years will be comfortable for people to listen to great music. So tonight, as Melvin said, we're going to hear five new works by five young composers, five new works performed by five young composers, performed by seven musicians, also very young, from all over the world, who came 9 days ago as individual masters of their instruments and have now joined together to make a band. They're all together, you'll see. They, under the direction of Lisa Moore, they found their way to become a coherent and consistent performing group, and that's a wonderful experience. A very brief word about why Beethoven. Why did I do this? I wanted to. There's a great Thoreau, a fellow New Englanders of ours, Henry David, author of Walden, famously says in Walden that one generation abandons the enterprises of another like so many stranded vessels. And for new generations, sometimes there is a desire and perhaps a need, a necessity, to abandon the enterprises of the generations that preceded them. But I think it's my job in some ways, a person who both loves old music, the music of now, and yearns for the music that is to come, I think it's my job to go aboard those stranded vessels and rescue what is still vital, what still excites, what still can be learned from, what can be put to use by our younger colleagues when they address the problems of making new music. In the back of the hall, there's a marble bust of Beethoven that sits up there.
Oh, yeah.
But marble or not, we should never forget that what is really enduring about that, about Beethoven, is the music, the sound of it, the excitement of it. So I made this reduction for this small chamber group to put on the stage, and I encouraged my younger colleagues to take from it an example of a composer who attempted to make something deeply vivid, expressive, and demonstrative in that music, something communicative, something powerful in that. And they all did that, each in their own way. For Beethoven, when he wrote this work around 1809, He was not writing Shakespeare's Coriolanus. He had a friend who wrote a Coriolan, but he was attempting to come to terms in his music with the drama and the tragedy of the tyrant who takes over the populace, makes war, lays waste to the countryside. What is the result of that? I think Beethoven's Coriolan Overture gives us an unforgettable picture of it. And now I'd like to bring out the wonderful ensemble, Lisa Moore, and the great seven. The Magnificent Seven. still can make the hair stand up on the back of my neck. It's pretty exciting. So at this point, it gives me great pleasure to introduce the first of our younger colleagues this evening, Stella, Willoughby, and here she is.
Good evening. My name is Stella G. Gitelman Willoughby, and I am the composer of Late Eclipses in the Sun and Moon. What you will hear tonight is a compositional work in progress. My experience at the Norfolk New Music Workshop has been a uniquely amazing and valuable learning opportunity. When I initially wrote Late Eclipses in the Sun and Moon, I had a very clear narrative and concept in mind. I now feel slightly differently. This composition is now both defined by and continuing to evolve based on what I have learned and the skills I have developed at this incredible workshop. An invaluable and critical part of my learning process has been having opportunities for formal and informal conversations and instruction from the knowledgeable, wise, and deeply inspiring Dr. Martin Bresnick and Dr. Lisa Moore. Collaborating and interacting with these dedicated and hardworking musicians, thank you so much for your incredible work. Learning from the insights of guest composers, Yale faculty members, and listening to the strengths and beauty of the other fellows' works, and having the quiet space and time to reflect on and to begin to incorporate feedback and new ideas. I am excited and eager to further develop what I have learned and incorporate new experiences and perspectives into my ongoing and future work and collaboration. Thank you very much to everyone who has helped make this meaningful learning opportunity and performance possible at every step along the way. And I want to take a special moment to thank my father, who fell down this evening on his way here. I don't know if anybody saw him outside, but he's worked so hard to support my career, and I am just so grateful for every moment and every bit of hard work that he has put into supporting my academic and musical career. And I'm so grateful and so sad that he could not. Thank you as well to the Ellen Battelle Stockel and Yale School of Music for believing in the importance of new music and for introducing the historic tradition of new music at Norfolk. And thank you, above all, to the audience for continuing to support and encourage this lasting tradition. I am truly and enormously grateful. I hope you enjoy Late Eclipses in the Sun and Moon.
Thank you. you all so much for being here. My name is Paul Novak, and I'm the composer of this next piece on the program, which is called Gravity Dancing. This piece is the latest in a series of pieces that I've been writing really since the beginning of the pandemic, which was such a scary and isolating time that I really wanted to write music which was comforting to play and had a lot of excitement and animation to it. And so I started writing these sets of dances, of which this is the fourth, I think. And the unifying idea in this set of dances is the idea of gravity, of downward motion. So these are all dances which fall. But throughout this piece, you'll hear falling in a variety of affects and characters and moods. You'll hear downward gestures which are high and also which are low. You'll hear ones which are loud and ones which are soft and gentle and ones which are very furious and angry. I just want to say, before you hear this piece, thank you so much to Martin and Lisa for directing this festival. And most of all, thank you so much to the fellows. This has been such a lovely and rewarding collaborative experience for me. And I owe you all so much. Thank you all so much, and I hope you enjoy Gravity Dances.
next piece, which is loosely based on a lecture by Foucault called On the Order of Discourse. I won't claim to have a perfect understanding of this pretty difficult text, which is why I need to organize my thoughts like this instead of speaking more off the cuff like I might otherwise want to. But maybe this adds a fun reflexive layer that maybe come up here in a second. Because in this text, Foucault lays out this understanding that we have these things called primary texts, like your Shakespeare's, the Bible, Foucault lectures, things that can be deep wells of meaning understood from multiple angles by the secondary texts, like dissertations, articles, or pre-concert talks. His point is that this is actually a totally arbitrary hierarchy, and the selection of what we think about as a primary or a secondary text is predetermined by much murkier things like cultural values or material processes. It's hard to see these on the surface, play out in real life, but it's not so different to a piece of music where the process is comparatively a little simpler. We pick the material and we sculpt it on the page. The performers filter the notation through their own interpretive lenses, and everybody in the audience interprets the sonic result according to their own biases and tastes. Each new piece of music, therefore, is a discursive environment of its own. So that's the focus of this piece, which is a little confusing since it basically means it's music about music. But I tried to go about accomplishing this by bringing the communicative flavor to the surface. So everything is either materially determined by the contour of pitch or the rhythm of a spoken word. From various primary texts, which I'll keep secret. Or is otherwise a less specific vocal artifact, whispering, grunting, shouting, moaning, weeping. So hopefully the result is the transformation of compositional technique into a representation of how I'm talking to these guys and how they're talking to you. Speaking of which, thank you very much. You guys are ridiculous, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
name is Yeeun Sim, a composer who wrote the next piece, Solitary Iceberg. It is truly a big honor to have my piece premiered in Norfolk New Music Workshop. Briefly speaking about my piece, I use the imagery of iceberg as a symbolization of a space inside your mind that holds you and supports you when you're in excessive circumstances. I hope you can explore your own iceberg in this soundscape and think about your inner world. Lastly, I would like to say thank you to these amazing musicians and Dr. Lisa Moore and Dr. Martin Bresnick for showing a great appreciation of my music and helping me throughout the whole workshop. Thank you so much for coming to the concert. Hope you enjoy Solitary Iceberg.
Thank you. Thank you.
Overture. My piece is called Spirals, and the reason it's called Spirals is because the piece focuses on two themes, and they kind of randomly exist, and they thought to themselves, well, we're here, we might as well make a piece together. And they're very adamant that they'll be in this piece, and they'll coexist, but they'll remain separate. And over the course of the piece, they realize that they're not contrasting, they're not separate, they're not cohesive, but they're actually two halves to a complete musical idea that will loop on itself and spiral, if not manually stopped, into infinite. First of all, before the piece is performed, I'd like a special thanks to Professor Bresnick and Professor Seymour for all of their wonderful guidance and support. And of course, the marvelous seven. Without them, my piece would just be notes on the page. So thank you so much, and I hope you all enjoy. Thank you.